Hello friends, this video on Wave Optics Part 31 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Please make sure that you have watched all the videos till Part 30 before going ahead with Part 31. So now we will look at polarization by reflection and refraction. So how reflection and refraction polarize light. Let us suppose this is the boundary. This is my incident ray, this is the normal, this is my reflected ray, and this is my refracted ray. Right? So here on the incident ray, we have unpolarized light. So how do we denote unpolarized light? Unpolarized light is denoted in this way, where the dot represents the plane perpendicular to the direction of incident ray, and this line indicates the direction, where dot represents the direction along the plane of the paper, and this represents parallel to the plane of the paper, and this represents perpendicular to the plane of the paper, right? So what happens when this ray is incident on this boundary? Some of the rays reflected and the remaining is refracted. So this is my angle of incidence, this is my angle of refraction, right? Now it was analyzed and found that most of the light in the reflected ray, they are polarized parallel to the plane with a very few unpolarized component, whereas most of the light along the refracted ray is unpolarized with one or two polarized component. So that means both the reflected ray and the refracted ray, both of them are partially polarized. The refracted light wave is more unpolarized and the reflected light wave is more polarized. So this was found. Now it was also observed that as the angle of incidence was varied, that means as the ray was made to fall incident from this side, what happened? More and more unpolarized light wave kept entering inside the surface. It was something like this. Let us suppose you have two components, one vertical component and one parallel component. Now, if you incline it more in this way, more and more will enter inside. It is something like if you have a sharp object, and if you have the ground, if you try to throw that sharp object towards the ground, it will go inside the ground, right? But if the object is blunt, it will not go inside the ground. Instead, it will bounce back. So similar thing is happening here. These components are the perpendicular components. So they are the sharp components. So when you project it in such a way that most of them go inside, that is why most of the unpolarized light get into the refracted wave. And very few of the parallel components bounces back and form the reflected ray. Now, if you change this angle of incidence, if this angle of incidence had been from this point, then what happened? Very few of the components entered inside, and also this became more unpolarized. Similarly, it was found that as the angle of incidence, there was a particular value of angle of incidence at which this reflected ray was maximum polarized. So below that value of incidence and above that value of incidence, both the waves were partially polarized. So the bottom line here is that when an unpolarized light falls on a boundary, both the reflected wave and the refracted wave are partially polarized. The reflected wave is more polarized and the refracted wave is more unpolarized. Here we'll talk about the Brewster's law, which talks about the variation in polarization with the angle of incidence, which I was talking about in the previous slide. At any particular angle of incidence, the reflected ray is completely polarized. There is a particular value for which this angle of incidence is called Brewster's angle, for which the reflected ray is completely polarized, and at such situation, the angle between the reflected and refracted ray is 90 degree. That means this angle is 90 degree under such situation, right? Now, if you change this angle, if this angle is changed to some value here, again this will become little unpolarized. If you change this value and tilt it a little more, then what will happen? More and more unpolarized wave will enter inside this medium, right? So that means there is this value of angle of incidence for which the reflected wave is completely polarized. Other than this value, everywhere the reflected ray and the refracted ray both are partially polarized. So this we can find out an expression for the Brewster's angle. This angle of incidence is known as Brewster's angle, after this, which is named after this law. So at I is equal to IB, what happens? When angle of incidence is equal to the Brewster's angle, that time this total angle is equal to 90 degree, right? Now from Snell's law, we know that sine I by sine R is equal to mu. What is sine I? Sine I is nothing but sine IB, because angle of incidence is Brewster's angle. What is angle R? R is nothing but this angle of refraction. So what is this angle of refraction? That will be nothing but pi by 2 minus Brewster angle. Why is it so? That's because the angle, it is told that the angle between reflected and refracted ray is 90 degree. That means this angle is 90 degree. So what is this angle? If you look at it, this angle IB, angle of incidence, is always equal to angle of reflection. So that means this is IB. This is IB, this total is 90 degree. So we have to find out this angle. So if this is IB and this is 90, see, this is angle IB, because angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. This total angle is 90. So that means what is this angle? This angle is equal to 90 degree minus IB. Again, this total angle is equal to 90 degree. So that means what is this angle? This angle is IB. So this is IB and this is angle of refraction. Therefore, we can write IB plus R is equal to 90 degree. So we can say R is equal to 90 degree minus IB. So that is what we have written here. This is equal to mu. So sine 90 minus theta is nothing but cos theta. So we can write it as cos IB. This is equal to mu. Therefore, we can write tan IB is equal to mu. So this is the expression for Brewster angle. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thank you once again.